Welcome to World Action and Reaction News. Today we are starting new video weekly series. Today we discuss pros and cons of Chandu J-20 stealth fighter. China's J-20 stealth fighter is making headlines around the world for obvious reasons. While the plane has been seen in various testing phases for some years now, the aircraft just made its official debut at an airshow in China, a symbol of Beijing's growing military muscle. Combined with China's new aircraft carrier, with the second now nearing completion, the first built in a Chinese shipyard, by the way, various types of advanced anti-ship weapons, multiple versions of advanced submarines and more, Beijing clearly is on a course, many argue already is, to become one of the world's most dangerous military powers, alongside Russia and America. But how would China's new stealth jet do in open warfare? Could it really tangle with the world's best? Here is a question: what about a matchup against Russia's new fifth-generation fighter, the PAK-FA? Last year, TNI's defense editor, Dave Majumdar, explored this question. So who would win? Let the debate begin. Russia and China have recently moved closer together as they collaborate to limit U.S. influence around the globe. However, relations between the two great powers have not always been so cozy. Indeed, the People's Republic of China and the Soviet Union even fought a brief undeclared border war in 1969, shattering the illusion of a monolithic communist bloc. While China and post-Soviet Russia have recently been drawn together, there is always the possibility that in the future their interests may diverge. In the event of conflict, air power would play a key role. So how might Russia's Sukhoi T-50 PAK-FA fare against the Chinese Chengdu J-20? That would depend on the type of conflict. Indeed, as I have noted before, while the PAK-FA is definitely an air superiority fighter, it's not clear that the J-20 is a fighter at all. If there was war in Russia's Far East, where a conflict with China might take place, range will be an important factor. While there is no specific information available about the range performance of either the J-20 or PAK-FA, given the size of the Chinese aircraft, one suspects it has longer legs. It probably also has a much greater payload. Overall, the J-20 could be the more useful machine if it was used as a strike aircraft. It's hard to say what would happen if the two aircraft were to meet head-on in an aerial battle. There has never been an instance where two stealth aircraft have met in an air-to-air encounter. Until recently, the Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor was the only operational stealth fighter on the planet. Previous aircraft like the F-117 and the B-2 are obviously optimized for air-to-ground attacks. If the J-20 and PAK-FA prove to be genuinely stealthy, an aerial engagement might devolve into a within-visual-range dogfight. That's assuming the two opposing forces could find each other. One might imagine that low-frequency radar would be able to direct the groups of jets into the right vicinity. The Russian and Chinese jets might then be able to locate each other more precisely using their infrared search and track capabilities. However, discerning accurate range data from an infrared sensor is problematic, and it's not clear if either the Russian or Chinese can derive a weapons quality track from those cameras. Thus, neither side would necessarily be able to shoot from any great range. That means the two opposing forces would be forced into a visual range fight. The J-20, which is powered by engines intended for the Sukhoi Su-27, is at a huge disadvantage. Compared to the PAK-FA, the J-20 is underpowered and wouldn't have the energy addition to keep up. Moreover, the PAK-FA has three-dimensional thrust vectoring for outstanding low-speed handling. That means the Russian aircraft probably has the edge in turn rate, turn radius, and high angle of attack performance. But if both sides have high off-boresight missiles and helmet-mounted queuing systems, with a little luck, the J-20 might get a lucky shot. However, the PAK-FA probably still has the edge. During study of J-20, we found few issues that make this fighter vulnerable. J-20 very basics of RCS reduction are 1. Small size geometric area exposed to radar is a big factor. J-20 is huge. 2. Shaping directivity is another major aspect of stealth. It is about how the radar transmissions strike the aircraft surface and how they are bounced off from the surface in a direction away from the radar. J-20 is bad in that aspect also. Its sides, front, and rear do not have the required angle to give it stealth. 3. Reflectivity. You have to use a skin made of such a structure which allows for lesser radar returns. It's same as you bouncing off a ball from a wall and bouncing it off a rubber ball. Which one of them will have more energy for the reflection? 4. Edge alignment. Have a look at J-20 and you will know that its edges are not at all aligned. 5. One thing, canards, although PAK-FA has leading edge root extension, mean they kind of act like canard as they fall down and lift up. Chinese have full canards which might increase frontal RCS. 6. The fan blade. I guess they might end up using radar block or something of the Super Hornet sorts. 7. The concept of PAK-FA is different to rest fighter. They still believe in agility and seek first destroy first with longer range missile. J-20 has internal bays and that reduces its loaded RCS and that is the only stealth it has. But that also is fine as long as we are looking at only I/J-band stealth. The way forward is internal weapons bays with electronic stealth. Rafale has electronic stealth but does not have internal weapon bays. Other problems, 1. Unsubstantiated claims on AESA with 1852T/R modules though no scientific study or data reveals how NRIAT ables master package technology in such short time which even Russians and Europeans struggled to master with generations of experience in aviation. Purchase of IBRIS-E was done to reverse engineer it to develop AESA technology for J-22. Radar heating issues and peak power generation in AESA major issues. 3. Use of radar coatings and RAM paint but unlike F-35 and F-22 is not baked in fiber-baked stain structure. 4. Under power engines reliability on Russians for next-gen engines which cause maintenance issues. 5. Unproven weapons and missile package less reliable seeker technology. 6. Lack or sensor fusion and active cancellation. 7. Unreliable EU package.